Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
May I request everyone to stand up, please. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Why not go around and greet your neighbors? Happy Resurrection Sunday. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Amen. Praise God. And if you've noticed, you know, because it's Resurrection Sunday, if you notice, we were joking around about this, that's why someone in front of you has resurrected as well. Kami pong mga oldies ay nag-resurrect dahil Resurrection Sunday. But the truth is, we're here to keep encouraging everyone, particularly those who have talent in singing, you know, in playing instruments. No, we're encouraging you to join the worship team. Amen. I'm sure you don't want your worship leaders to be in front of you, even they're old enough that they're carrying their own canes and then still worship leading, right? Yeah, so if you have talents in worship leading, in singing, join the worship team. Amen. Hallelujah. Let me read to you Psalm 65, verse 8. It says, "Those who live at the ends of the earth stand in awe of your wonders. From where the sun rises to where it sets, you inspire shouts of joy." And also in Psalm 68, verse 33 to 35, "Sing to the one who rides across the ancient heavens, his mighty voice thundering from the sky. Tell everyone about God's power. His majesty shines down on Israel. His strength is mighty in the heavens. God is awesome in his sanctuary. The God of Israel gives power and strength to his people. Praise be to God." So the key word here is word awe and awesome. The word awe refers to the feeling of reverential respect with fear and even surprise. No, worship. And that's our role. No, to be in awe in the presence of our God. For truly awesome. No, God is awesome. And that word belongs to our God only. Amen?
Amen.
In the olden days, you know, in the old English, the word awesome and awful carries the same meaning. No, they carry the same meaning. You know, it's like, you know, it's filled with awe. It's full of awe. But nowadays we know that the word awful is the reversed meaning of it. Now I was joking around this morning. The only awful, no, that is good is the awfully chocolate. Right? But nowadays, the word awful is the reverse meaning of awesome.
Amen.
Know that if you look even in the King James Version, the word awesome actually is represented by the word terrible and terrifying. Which nowadays, kung titingnan natin, hindi natin ginagamit yung terrible, eh, ibig sabihin eh, the opposite meaning, right? But right now, we will declare that our God is awesome. Amen? He is awesome and He deserves all the power, the glory, and the honor. Hallelujah. And we rejoice today because He is risen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Yes, God, you are have risen, O God, and we will celebrate today. Hallelujah. He is risen. He is risen. And he lives. Come on, church, declare it. Forevermore. He is risen. He is risen. Come on and celebrate. Come on, church, let's celebrate. Come on and celebrate. Come on and celebrate. The resurrection of our Lord. Yes, declare it, he's awesome in this place. Hallelujah. Here in this house.
Here in this house of the great King. We come together now to worship. Is built on Christ our rock.
Cannot be shaken.
Cannot be shaken. Cannot be shaken.
Yes, he's awesome.
God is awesome in this way. We sense his presence as we sing his reign. There is power here for a miracle. Set the captives free and make the broken whole. God is awesome. He's so awesome. God is awesome in this place.
Here in this house.
Here in this house of the great King. We come together now to worship.
Yes, Lord.
This house is built on our rock.
Declare it.
Cannot be shaken. Cannot be shaken.
God is awesome.
God is awesome. Since his presence, as we sing his praise. There is power here for a miracle to set the captives free and make the broken whole.
God is awesome.
God is awesome. He's so awesome. God is awesome in this way.
I found where I belong. Declare it, church. Hallelujah.
I found where I belong. I'm a living stone. In this house I will grow.
Yes, God.
I found where I belong. I'm a living stone. In this house I will grow.
Yes.
I found
where I'm a living word.
In this house I will grow.
Once again,
I found where
I'm a believing word.
In this house I will go.
There is power.
There is power here for a miracle to set the captives free and make the broken whole.
God is awesome.
God is awesome. He's so awesome. God is awesome in this place.
He is risen.
Oh, he is risen. He is risen. And he lives forevermore. He is risen. He is risen.
Come on and celebrate.
Come on, celebrate.
The resurrection.
The resurrection of our Lord.
He He is risen.
He is risen. He is risen. And he lives
forevermore. Yes, Lord.
He is risen. He is risen. Come on and celebrate.
Come on and celebrate.
I want to celebrate.
Come on and celebrate.
I want to celebrate.
Come on and celebrate.
I want to celebrate.
I want to celebrate. The resurrection.
The resurrection of our Lord.
Yes, God, we celebrate. For you have risen, oh God. Truly you are awesome, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, for being here in this house, oh God. Truly, your awesome is presence, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. You are an awesome God.
When he rose up his sleeve and just putting on the rest, there is thunder in his footstep and lightning in his face. And the Lord wasn't joking when he kicked them out of Eden. It wasn't for no reason that he shed his blood. He's returning very soon, so you better be believing that our God is an awesome.
Come on, church, declare it.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above. He dwells in power, love. Our God is an awesome.
Our God is an awesome God.
Our God. He's an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above. With wings and power and love. God is an awesome God.
Hallelujah.
When he rose up his sleeve, angels put him on the rest. There is thunder in his footstep and lightning in his face. And the Lord wasn't joking when he kept him out of Eden. It wasn't for no reason that he shed his blood. His return is very soon, so you better be believing that our God is an awesome.
First God,
our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, love. Our God is an awesome.
Declare it,
our God. He's an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, love. Our God is an awesome.
Let's sing it one more time. Our God
is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, love. Our God is an awesome.
The voices sing.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns.
Yes, he reigns.
Heaven above with wisdom, power, love. Our God is an
awesome God.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, love. Our God is an
awesome God. He reigns.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns. From heaven above, with wisdom, power, love. Our God is an awesome.
Our God is an awesome God.
Our God is an awesome God. God, he reigns from heaven above, with wisdom, power, love. Our God is an awesome.
Our God is an awesome God.
Our God is an awesome God. Our God is awesome.
Truly, you are awesome, Lord. You are our awesome God. And no one else, Lord, deserves that, Lord. Truly, you're the only one who is awesome, who is powerful, who is mighty. You are our awesome God, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. And Father, as we come into your presence, may we keep, Lord, that feeling of awe in front of you. God, that reverential respect, Lord, that we have for you, May we always declare, not only in our lips, but even in our hearts, that you are our awesome, mighty, blessed God, oh God. Father, we just want to exalt you here in our midst today. Praise you, Jesus. As I come into your presence, past the gates of praise, into your sanctuary, you're standing face to face. I look upon your countenance, I see the fullness of your grace, and I can only bow down and say, come on, church, declare it. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. Let's sing it from the beginning. As I come into your presence, as the gates of praise, into your sanctuary, till we're standing face to face, I look upon your countenance, I see the fullness of your grace, and I can only bow down and say, declare it, church, you are awesome in this world, mighty are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome, Lord. You are awesome in this place, Lord, you are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, my King. Sing it one more time. Hallelujah. Praise you, God. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. Yes, you are awesome. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. Yes, Lord, truly you are awesome, God. And as we have that feeling of awe, Lord, we want to worship you, exalt you here in our midst, God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. In awe of you, Your voices, hallelujah.
Now your presence fills this place. Be exalted in our praise as we worship. I believe you are near.
Now your presence fills this place, Lord. Your power, Lord,
exalted in our praise.
Fill it with your presence,
sweet worship. I believe you are near.
Know your presence, hallelujah. Yes, Lord,
now your presence fills this way.
Your blessing, honor, power, and glory, Lord. Hallelujah.
Blessing and honor and glory and power forever, forever. Blessing and honor and glory and power forever. Blessing and honor and glory and power forever, forever.
Lift your voices.
Blessing and honor and glory and power forever, forever.
Blessing, honor, and glory.
Blessing and honor and glory and power forever, forever.
Blessing,
blessing, honor and glory and power forever, forever.
Oh, it's Lord, we bless you with our hearts. Adore you, Lord. Hallelujah. church, lift up your voices. Sing to the Lord a new song. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We exalt you, O Lord, for truly you are an awesome God. Oh God, we worship you. We exalt you, Lord. You deserve, Lord, blessing, honor, blessing and honor. Come on, church, declare it. In all you. Come on, church, lift up your voices. I stand in awe of you. Holy God, to whom all praise is due, I stand in awe of you. One more time, lift up your voices. I stand in awe of you. I stand in awe of you. Holy God, to whom all praise is due, I stand in awe of you. Holy God, holy God, to whom all praise is due, I stand in awe of you.
Hallelujah. Of your Holy Spirit this afternoon. Hallelujah. You deserve our praise, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. In the Gospel of John, specifically in verses 14 to 22, we encounter the account of Jesus cleansing the temple. In verse 14, Jesus demonstrates his disapproval by driving out those who were engaging in unlawful practices within the sacred space. His actions reveal his profound reverence for this holy place. Jesus emphasizes its sanctity by referring to it as my Father's house. However, there is another temple mentioned in verses 19 to 22. We read that Jesus answered them, "Destroy this temple, and I will raise it again in 3 days." In this passage, Jesus symbolically referred to his own body as a temple that would be raised up after 3 days. This now highlights the concept of his body being the dwelling place of the Father on earth. It encompasses more than just a physical structure. It also signifies a sacred space where the presence of the Father resides. When Jesus spoke, his words hinted at his resurrection, emphasizing the spiritual significance of his sacrifice and the eventual restoration of the temple. Although the Jews at that time did not fully grasp the depth of Jesus' message, the disciples later recalled his words and placed their faith in the profound truth he conveyed. So, what is the significance of this message for us today? You see, as God's people, how do we ought to respond to the Father's love for us? In 1 Corinthians 3:16 to 17, believers are also described as God's temple. We are God's dwelling place. The Holy Spirit dwells within us. This metaphor underscores that the church, which includes us, serves as a unique body set apart by God to display His character. We are also God's dwelling place. As believers, we are now the dwelling place of God. Just as the temple was consecrated and set apart, we too are sanctified by God to carry His presence within us. Jesus revered His Father's house, recognizing its sacredness. Likewise, we should honor God's presence within us. Our bodies are not ordinary. They are vessels for the Holy Spirit. We should treat them with reverence and care. You see, Jesus, He willingly allowed Himself as God's temple to be used by the Father, even to the extent of His own death. Similarly, we should yield ourselves to God's purposes. His grace and mercy transform our lives when we surrender to His will. Just as the temple was a place and worship of worship and sacrifice, our lives become an offering to God. As God's temple, our response should be one of gratitude, obedience, and love. We recognize that we are vessels of His Spirit, and our lives should reflect His character. We seek to honor Him in all we do, relying on His grace and mercy to guide us. Understanding ourselves as God's temple calls us to live in reverence, humility, and alignment with the will of the Father. So may this not only be a season of celebration, but also a moment for reflection. As God's temple, let us follow the teachings of our Master Jesus, choosing grace over injustice, forgiveness, not bitterness, and love over hatred. Let us pray. Father, we just want to thank You. We just want to honor Your name. We just want to thank You for Your love, Your grace, and mercy to each and every one of us. We thank You, Father, because out of Your conditional love, You allowed Your Son, Jesus Christ, to die, to suffer for our sins. He took our place, and now we have hope. We have joy in serving and knowing You. And so, Lord, we just want to thank You. And as a response, Father, remind us that it is our duty to respond in love, in grace, and mercy, just as how the Lord Jesus Christ showed this to us. We thank You, O Lord. Allow Your Holy Spirit to work in our midst this afternoon. And we give You back all the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name we pray, and all the people will say, Amen.
Good afternoon, church. Happy Easter, everyone. Thank you, and let us continue to be in the spirit of worship as we pray for our tithes and offering. May I invite everyone, please, to read with me from the verses of Scripture, from 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 10 to 11. Please read with me. He who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed for sowing and increasing the harvest of your righteousness. You will be enriched in every way to be generous in every way, which through us will produce thanksgiving to God. Let our response to the word be, as we give in today's offering, we recognize the God who is faithful to supply all his creatures' physical needs and is kind to all people, and that he is uniquely generous to his children. He always fulfills his promise to replenish their generosity because of his loving, gracious, faithful, and merciful character. Let's pray. Father God, in Jesus' name, we are here to lovingly offer you that which you have bestowed on us. Thank you that you can make all grace abound towards us and to abound in us, to give a large increase of spiritual and of temporal good things. You can make us have enough in all things and to be content with what we have. You not only give enough for ourselves, but that we may supply the needs of others. Through this, may we also demonstrate our obedience to the gospel by works of charity and as evidence of what we profess as Christians to the praise and glory of your name. Let us seek to copy the example of Christ, being unwearied in doing good and deeming it more blessed to give than to receive. Bless the fruit of our hands that we will offer lovingly for the works of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us all give lovingly and cheerfully to our ever-living God. Juncture, we would like to acknowledge the presence of our guests. Allow me to welcome our visitors from the Philippines, who are our co-workers and brethren in the Lord. As I call on your name, Paul, would you kindly stand so that we can see you? Pastor Lorenzo de Guzman Jr., welcome, Paul. Please remain standing. Pastora Cynthia de Guzman, welcome, Paul. Pastor Noel Lacson and his wife, Pastora Lorna Lacson. Welcome to Living Word Fellowship, and as you come and stay in Singapore po, may you enjoy the presence of the brethren in fellowship with Christ at yung pong inyong pagtutur ng Singapore. Welcome po. And later we will welcome them as well. Thank you po. Let me sit down. And we would also like to acknowledge the presence of our first-time guests. As I call your name, similarly, kindly stand po so we can all see you. Miss Sutranari. Sutranii. Nasaan po siya? Okay. Ay, hi. Hi. Miss Madonna Sanchez. Welcome po. Please remain standing. Miss Digna Tumali. Welcome. And Miss Annalyn Madriaga. Welcome po. Welcome to Living Word Fellowship. We are a full gospel Christian church. And later po, your welcome host will be with you for 5 minutes or so to get to know you a little better and to also introduce who we are as a church. Before that po, bago natin sila pag-pray, meron po ba nag-join sa atin for the second, third time? Or even fourth? Welcome, ate. Thank you very much. And we hope you'll make this your home church as you walk in faith in the knowledge and grace of God. Shall we all stretch forth our hands to our guests and pray for them? Father God, in Jesus' name, we thank you for Miss Sutrani, Madonna, Digna, and Annalyn for being here with us. And as they hear your word, Lord, may they thirst and hunger for your presence, Lord God. And may they come to the saving knowledge and grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. To put their faith in Him, to repent, to receive His forgiveness, Lord, and the gift of eternal life with you. Lord, in whatever circumstance that they are in, and whatever they carry as burden in their hearts, may they slowly come to trust you in your loving kindness, in your faithfulness. We lift them, Father, to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And let us all stand up, po. Welcome one another, and especially extend that welcome to our guests from the Philippines and from our first-time guest. To our first-time guest.
Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord! Yan, today po ay special day. Today is Resurrection Sunday. Amen? Amen? And we want to celebrate the resurrection of Christ. But we do have some simple performances by our praise dance and even some of our young adults. So let's just prepare our heart to be ministered. So ngayon po ang ating praise dance will be doing a rendering of a song, of a powerful song. So let's just welcome our praise dancers.
Was a wretch, I remember who I was. I was lost, I was blind, I was running out of time. Sin separated, the breach was far too wide. But from the far side of the chasm, you held me in your sight. So you made a way across the great divide. Left behind heaven's throne to build it here inside. And there at the cross you paid the debt I owe. Broke my chains, freed my soul for the first time I. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood applied. Thank you, Jesus, it has washed me white. Thank you, Jesus, you have saved my life. Brought me from the darkness into glorious light. Took my place, laid inside my tomb of sin. You were buried for 3 days, but then you walked right out again. And now death has no sting, and life has no.
Hasn't always been this way. I remember brighter days before the dark ones came, stole my mind, wrapped my soul in chains. Now I live among the dead, fighting voices in my head, hoping someone hears me crying in the night. It carries me away. Set me free. Me crying in the rain, all alone with my demons I am. Who is this man that comes my way? The dark ones shriek, they scream his name. Is this the one they say will set the captive free? Jesus, rescue me, set me free. Oh, the chains holding me. Is anybody out there hearing me? Set me free. And as the God wanna be free. Lift your chains, I hold the key. All power on heaven and earth belong to me. Do you wanna be free?
Call me.
Lift your chains.
Chapter 8, verse 36. So if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Palakpakan natin ating Panginoon. Many of us can relate to that story. We once chained into sin, but because of Jesus, we have been set free. Amen?
Amen.
We thank the Lord for His goodness in our lives, and we thank Praise Dance for rendering a wonderful dance number, reminding us that we are safe in the Lord. Before we dive into God's Word, let me highlight a few announcements. Few is firstly our early morning prayer. We have our early morning prayer Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 5 a.m. to 5:45, and then on Sunday, 6 a.m. Kung available po kaya, please join us sa ating early morning prayer. And also this coming week, our midweek prayer will be sa ating online Facebook page. That's what's at 9 p.m. So join us sa ating mga prayer time. So you know, we've been really encouraging all of us to pray. And also today we just started our IBI Biblical Prophecy, and we have started, ito po commence today, but if you want and you're interested to be part of our IBI class, do sign up, get to Tita Eba and connect sa iConnect. Next week also we have our water baptism. Ito po, yan. If you have surrendered your life to Jesus and also you want to publicly declare that you belong to Him, please sign up para ma-send po namin yung mga details, logistics. So, we will have water baptism next week. And we just completed our prayer seminar last month. This month, the coming months, we will be focusing on evangelism. So, how among you ay, it's been many years that you share the gospel. Taas kamay. What? Every week yun nag-share? You know, some of us has not been sharing, but you know, some of us are shy, natatakot, or ill-equipped. We have don't know how to really share the gospel. So, I pray that itong evangelism training will minister to us, to train us, starting for next week. In between service, 10:30 to 11:30, ang topic po natin, firstly, is week one, the heart of evangelism, what, why, and the joy of evangelism. And then week two, a community evangelism. How can we go out and reach out? And then week three, relational evangelism. Practical ways on how we can reach out our families, our friends, our employers, at mga kaibigan natin sa community. And there's also week four, we'll be focused on launching and going out. We want to, thank you, go out and minister sa mga kapatiran natin. Yan. So, sabi mo sa katabi mo, join tayo. Yan, and it's open to everyone, care group leader, ministry leaders, it's open to all. I know some of us has not been sharing, and you know, the Lord calls us to share the word, the gospel to the lost. And then we would like to focus on prayer. This coming week, we will have overnight prayer. So 9 April, take note. It's a day before the holiday, overnight po dito. May mga segment po tayo, you can join us. And then after that, maybe in the middle of the night, maybe mga 1 a.m. in the morning, pwede na kayong umuwi kung gusto nyo. But you can join us. May segment po, but we want to pray and intercede. Also, all church prayer, 14 April, gathered here in between services. But we would like to also encourage you to take time to pray and fast. Ito po, 18 to 14, prayer and fasting. You know, the secret and the power of the church is not in our resources, in our ability, but simply in the power of God. Amen? We cannot experience breakthrough, we cannot experience the move of God unless the people would come and pray and seek the Lord and call upon His name. So as a church, we want to cultivate this posture of humility to come to the Lord in prayer. And also, mayroon pa po tayong last two announcement. We will have our church anniversary sa 28 April. Yan. Church anniversary, 27th year na tayo as Living Word. Pakalbak natin ang Panginoon. We'll be celebrating our church anniversary. It's only one service on that day, 10:30 or around 10 o'clock. We will give you the details of what are you expecting to have. So take note, sabihin nyo sa katabi mo, you're invited. Sabi ng organizer, ang dress code daw ay ano, anong dress code? Pilipinyana daw. Oh, traditional clothes. But we will send you the details of what we will have. You know, one thing about our church is so unique. Sino taga Cebu? Taas kamay. Isa lang. Taga, sino Ilocano? Sino Tagalog? Pampanga. See, everywhere, every tribe, you know, we are, it's not an accident why here. Sinong pango? All of us, you know, the reason why the Lord brought us here, why we are connected, is not because of our interests, but because of Jesus. Amen? Because of Jesus. Last call din po sa ating old church camp. Ito po, TLW church camp sa Benguet, 6 to 8 June. It's last call because by next day, April, we will open na po ito sa mga kapatiran natin na sa Pilipinas. Alright? Contact Sister Morel for more details. Praise the Lord. Turn to the person beside you and tell the person a blessed Resurrection Sunday. It's a privilege for us to have our pastors here na galing sa Malaysia. Nagka-retreat sila doon, and we thank the Lord sa kanilang presence today and even our guests today. You know, we thank the Lord for the opportunity that we once again gather here to remember that our Lord Jesus Christ did not stay on the grave, but instead on the third day, He rose again. Amen? Jesus has risen. And let me begin with this question. Question. Itanong mo sa katabi mo itong question na ito. This question is, why do you celebrate Resurrection Sunday? Tanong mo. At sagutin mo rin. Sige. Why do you celebrate Resurrection Sunday? Many of us Filipino, it's been our tradition. It's part of our life. It's a part of our being a Filipino. And surely some of you would reply, because Jesus has risen from the grave. And it's true. You know, you cannot say just, we cannot just focus on the crucifixion, but we also have to highlight the resurrection. The gospel has to be presented well, not just the crucifixion of Christ, but also His resurrection. We need to understand the importance of Christ's resurrection. Sabi dito sa Christianity.com, the resurrection of Jesus Christ is the cornerstone of the Christian faith, for it signified the fulfillment of God's plan for redemption and offering believers the promise of eternal life. It is a day of immense joy, sabihin mo joy, and hope as Christians celebrate the victory of light over darkness, life over death, and the triumph of God's love for humanity. So, ibig sabihin, may joy. Tingin mo katabi mo, may joy ba yan katabi mo? Do that person have joy? Turn to the other beside you. Then look at that person. Do that person have hope? That's the reason why we remember Jesus have risen, because we know that God's plan for redemption is offering us a life, eternal life, a life that's full. Now, all of us would agree with this, but I have a follow-up question, second question. Magki-quiz tayo ngayon. Ang next question is this: how then Christ's resurrection impact your life? Sige, mag-isip muna tayo na 30 seconds. Kung si Jesus ay namatay at nabuhay uli, how then it should impact my life? The church, the community. Most of us had iba-iba ang sagot. Some of us will not be able to answer it quickly. Sino naka-answer agad? Some of us don't know how to answer it. And most of us. Because it's the first time we really ponder this question. Kung we celebrate Resurrection Sunday, ano dapat ang impact sa aking buhay? You see, there's a danger na year after year, we celebrate and remember the Christ's resurrection. Religiously, it's part of our yearly tradition na ginagawa. Intellectually, we agree ang importance nito, ang value nito. However, we fail to comprehend how Christ's resurrection should affect our daily life. We understand it. We embrace the doctrine of it. Pero paano siya talaga nag-i-impact sa ating buhay? How should it influence the way we live our life? You see, my prayer that in this afternoon, we will have a deeper understanding of Christ's resurrection. That His resurrection brings transformative power and purpose in our life. I've entitled this sharing, Risen Jesus, and we'll be reading from the account of Matthew chapter 28, verse 1 to 10. And I invite all of us to stand as we give reverence to God's word. Matthew chapter 28, verse 1 to 10. Let's read together. Now after Sabbath, towards the dawn of the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, his clothing white as snow. And for fear of him, the guards trembled and became like dead men. But the angel said to the woman, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen, as he said. Come see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead. And behold, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. See, I have told you." So they departed quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came up and took hold of his feet and worship him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." Let's pray. Panginoon, salamat po sa tanghaling ito na narito po kami. Lord, as we remember that you have risen, I pray, Lord, na ito po ay hindi lang an event, a celebration, or a part of our calendar as Christian. But Lord, as we recognize and acknowledge that you have risen, I pray that you develop ang aming mga puso, that it will impact the way we live. Holy Spirit, come and lead your way this afternoon. And we ask, Lord, that your word will be spoken to each one of us. I pray that you soften our hearts. If any one of our hearts today that is hard, soften it. Lord, if any one of our hearts today that's broken, Lord, I pray that there will be healing and restoration. Holy Spirit, come, you're the great teacher, and we desire to hear from you, God. So we surrender all things, Señor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen. You may be seated. You see, the narrative that we have just read has three parts. May tatlong part po ito. The first part is this, a supernatural event in verse 1 to 4, and then verse 5 to 7, a grand revelation of Jesus' true identity, and thirdly, a reorientation of life. reorientation of life, specifically sa mga disciples. Now, let's look at the first point, a supernatural event. Sabihin mo sa katabi mo, supernatural. You see, Christ's supernatural resurrection was a supernatural event. And for us to appreciate how it is supernatural, how it was supernatural, what we will do is to observe yung surrounding. Ano ba nangyayari during the time siya namatay at nag-rise up? Let's observe. First thing, what happened? When Jesus died on the cross, Pilate and even the teachers of the law came together. They came together and what they do is they make sure that he have died. Ang ginawa nila ay pinuntahan nila to make sure that Jesus have died. And let's trace their action. So ang gagawin natin, pag-aralan natin, it is a supernatural event. So let's understand what's happening. So first thing what Pilate did is to confirm kung tunay na patay ni Jesus. Let's read this. In Mark 15 verse 44 to 45, si Joseph lumapit kay Pilate. Sabi niya, pwede bang ilibing na namin? You know the story. So in this text, sabi ni Pilate, Pilate was surprised to hear that he should have already died. Na-surprise si Pilate dahil bakit siya ay namatay agad? Now, in those times, pag ang tao ay na-crucified, hindi hours, it takes around at least 2 to 3 days for the person to die. 2 to 3 days. But in this text, si Jesus ay patay na. So ang ginawa niya, nag-summon siya ng centurion. Sabi, he summoned the centurion and asked him whether he is already dead. Ang isang centurion ay hindi siya low-ranking official or soldier. It's a person who's high-ranking. So he knows what he's doing. So pinuntahan niya at tiningnan, and when he learned from the centurion that he is dead, he granted the corpse of Joseph. So alam nila, is clearly in this text na si Jesus ay patay na. Now, hawakan mo yung katabi mo. Lumalamig ba yan? Bakit ba na yan, ha? Alam ni Centurion kung patay hindi kasi natural sa kanila yan. So here, kinonfirm nila, okay, si Jesus ay patay na. Alright? Now, there's another event. Secondly, the teachers of the law, the chief priests were so afraid because they in their mind, it's lingering. Ano sabi ni Jesus? Let me read to you. Matthew 27, 63 to 66. Sabi dito, Sir, this is the chief priest talking to Pilate. We remember how the imposter, this Jesus, said while he was still alive, after 3 days, I will rise. Gets nyo, etong teachers of the law, yung mga chief priests, nag-send to Jesus to be crucified, they were afraid na mabubuhay si Jesus. They were afraid. Said that after 3 days, he will rise. Therefore, verse 64, let me read 64. Therefore, order the tomb to be made secure until the third day. Etong mga teachers of the law, natatakot sila na mabuhay si Jesus. So, ang ginawa nila, ano? Basahin natin. You have a guard soldier. Have you ever thought ilan soldier ang pinadala? Ilan kaya? I did a study of it. Said, some scholars said it's around 16. 16 soldier. Hindi isa, hindi dalawa, hindi tatlo. 16. 16 soldier. And not only that, make it as secured as you can. Secured. Now, etong secured, sabi ng ibang scholar, hindi lang nila rinol yung big stone. Ang size ng stone ito is either 1.2 meter to 1.8 meter. And ang weight niya is around 200 kg to 2,000 kg. Sino sa inyo ay 2,000 kg dito? Mabigat. At renewal over and then linagyan pa ng seal. Sabi nila, linagyan pa daw ng parang plaster to make sure na walang makakalabas. Mahal malalabas. And then said, and they went and made a tomb secured by sealing the stone and setting a guard. Yung sealing na ito ay nalaglagay ng isang sign doon. Pag ginalaw to, lagot kayo sa Roman Empire. So, yun ang ginagawa. So they made it super secured na walang lalabas. But however, we read in the text that we have read that nothing can stop God from doing the impossible. Amen? In our text, we read in verse 2 to 4, and behold, there was great earthquake. Kahit anumang plano ni Pilate, kahit anong plano ng mga chief priests, there was an earthquake. Who can stop an earthquake? Wala. Wala silang mga gawa. Then an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. Rolled back the stone and sat on it. An angel of the Lord. Tingin mo katabi mo, mukha bang angel yan? An angel of the Lord rolled back. It's like lightning. I remember, sino nakapanood ng rock concert before dito? I went to a rock concert before. Hindi pa ako nagpapastun doon. When I went to a rock concert, there's one moment na yung tugtog, biglang zing. Yung light talaga ang lakas sa mata. And you will just be blinded. And I believe when the angel comes, it's like that. It's lightning. It's like lightning and white as snow. Not only stated here in the text, sabi, they roll back the stone. It's not a small stone, it's a big stone. And the text we read here is the guards trembled and became like dead men, na immobilized at powerless sila. You see, it was a supernatural and extraordinary event that happened. Iba siya. Kaya sabihin mo sa katabi mo, supernatural. Pero ang ginawa ng mga teachers of the law, mautak sila. Akala niyo yung fake news ay ngayon lang, may marunong na sila gumawa ng fake news noon. Basahin natin sa verse 12 and 13, sabi, and when they had assembled the elders and taken counsel, they gave sufficient some money to the soldier and said, tell people his disciple came the night and stole him away while we'll sleep. So kino-cover up ang reason, kino-cover up that really that Jesus has risen. They bribe the soldier and promise protection. What they need to do is just spread rumors. Mga chismoso tong soldier na ito. But we all know this. Nothing can stop the truth to be spread out. And how can 16 soldiers fall asleep? Si Pastor, nag-uusap kami kaganina, militar siya, Pastor. Dating militar. Pag nasa guard ka or soldier ka, hindi ka patulog-tulog na, Pastor. Hindi ka pwedeng patulog-tulog. Dapat awaken ka. Pag bumuhat ng malaking stone gising yan. You see, even if they tried to roll the big stone, they couldn't carry the body of Jesus. But you know what? All these things, why I'm setting all these things is because to highlight that Jesus' resurrection is supernatural. Brothers and sisters, the only possible explanation for Jesus' body to be missing from the tomb, it was because it was a divine action. Jesus' resurrection was supernatural events. Hence, it should remind us that to God, nothing is impossible. And it should awaken our faith. What we learn from this supernatural event is this. Man tries to control it, but God's plan will always prevail. Man tries to hide the truth, but God's truth will always be proclaimed. Man tries to operate in the natural, but God works in the supernatural. Man tries to end the story, but the real story has just begun. You see, the resurrection gives us hope to trust God and to look forward to our future. For Christ's resurrection reminds us how God works in extraordinary and in supernatural ways. Meron tayong pinagdadaanan, but there are times we should always look upon the Lord and trust that He can do the mighty thing. Amen? Kaya sabi mo sa atabi mo, supernatural. First, we learned that Jesus' resurrection was supernatural. Second, we learned that Jesus' resurrection was a grand revelation of who Jesus is. A grand revelation of Jesus' true identity. Sino nga ba si Jesus? That was the question. If prior to His resurrection, people have different idea kung sino si Jesus. Let me give you an example. At first, people considered Him as great teacher. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 28 to 29, and when Jesus finished teachings, the crowd were astonished at His teachings. Ang tingin kay Jesus ay isang teacher. In John chapter 3, verse 2, it says, this man came to Jesus that night and said, Rabbi, we know that you're a teacher come from the Lord. So iba-iba ang interpretation nila. The way they look at teachers, first they look at Him as teacher. But later part si Jesus ay nag-heal, He cast out demon, He walked on waters, and He feed the 5,000. And now later part, ang sabi, sino ba talaga si Jesus ngayon? First, they recognize Him as teacher, now as a prophet. We read in Matthew 16, verse 14. And they said, some said John the Baptist, others say Elijah, others Jeremiah, or one of the prophet. Not only a great teacher, a prophet, sa mga teachers of the law, sa mga scribes, ang tingin nila kay Jesus ay ano? Isang criminal. Isang imposter. A threat. Now lastly, the disciples. How do the disciples look at Jesus? You know, the disciples said, you are the Messiah. Pero problema of their understanding. They have limited understanding of who Jesus is. They look at Jesus as what? A military and political leader to rescue them from pagan rules. All these are the different description given to Jesus while He was serving on earth. Some of them may be wrong. Some of them are not really correct. However, Jesus' resurrection reaffirmed who He was, that He was truly God. And look at our narrative, verse 5 to 7. Sabi dito, but the angel of the Lord said to the woman, do not be afraid. Now, I would like to point this thing. Angel. The angel said to the woman, you see, an angel was the messenger of Jesus. Messenger of Jesus. If you study angels, sumusunod ba yun sa tao? Hindi. Sa Diyos lamang. Ang galing, no? Ang mga anghel, hindi sumusunod sa tao. Sa Diyos lamang. Kaya tingnan mo katabi, mukha bang anghel yan? Angels' duty was to serve God's purpose, not human being. But also here, how it highlighted that who God Jesus is. He is risen in verse 6, in verse 7. No longer dead, but alive. No longer lying inside the tomb. In my evidence pa, tingnan mo, wala na siya dito. See, Jesus conquered death. Jesus conquered the grave. But also take note of this, the word, He said here, He is not here for His reason, as He said. One clear, distinct character of God is that God holds His word truthfully. What He say, it will happen. He will never make a lie, He will hold His truth. What He say, it will come to pass. Amen? Remember last week, I talked about how Jesus knew and foresaw event na mangyayari sa Kanya. He said to His disciple that He said that He will suffer, He will be killed, and the third day He will rise again. In chapter 17, He said it again, He will be killed, but He will rise again. In Matthew 20, He said it again, that He will be condemned to death, He will be mocked, crucified, but in the third day, He will rise again. You see, one of God's distinct character is that He's a promise keeper, and He will fulfill His plan and His purpose. Ezekiel chapter 12, verse 28. Thus says the Lord God, none of my words will be delayed any longer, but the words that I speak will be performed, declares the Lord God. Therefore, Christ's resurrection reveals His true identity. He's not just a teacher. He's not just a prophet. He's not a criminal. He's not just a Messiah defined by man's way. But He's God. Part of a triune God. God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Kaya pag may lumapit sa inyo, nasa Lucky Plaza kayo, may lumapit sa inyo at sabi si, nandito na ang Son of God.
Nakatira siya sa Mindanao. Watch out. Pag may tanong sa inyo, sabihin nyo, napako na ba siya sa krus? Be careful. You see here clearly, Christ's resurrection revealed who He was, who He is. He's the Son of God. I love what Billy Graham said. Sabi ni Billy Graham, the resurrection meant first that Christ was undeniably God. He was what He claimed to be. Christ was deity in the flesh. First, we learn that Jesus Christ's resurrection is supernatural. And second, that it was a grand revelation of who Jesus is. Lastly, Jesus' resurrection will have an impact to the disciples' life. And this leads me to the last point. Reorientation of life. You see, 3 days has passed since Jesus' resurrection. The disciples were confused. The disciples were troubled. They were afraid. They don't know what will happen. They were greatly discouraged. And most of the disciples were hiding. There's an account in John chapter 20. Sabi dito, the disciples were fearful to the Jews. Ang ginawa nila, they hide himself in a room and lock the door. Takot na takot ang mga disciples. You see, everything happened so fast. And most of the disciples were so afraid and still in the state of shock. Now, how about the women that was with him? The women were grieving. One of them is Mary. They were still mourning and grieving for the loss of their master. John chapter 20, verse 11, but Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. In summary, when Jesus was crucified, for that past 3 days, the disciples were what? Distraught and hopeless. They were confused and aimless. Dahil sa problema ang pinagdadaanan nila, hindi nila alam ano next step. But we thank God because Jesus' resurrection begins to reorient their life. Look at our text, sabi dito. So they departed quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy and ran to tell disciples. And behold, Jesus met them and said, greetings. And they came up and took hold of his feet and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me. First thing we learn here is this. Because of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, the disciples who were distraught and hopeless, their hopelessness turns to what? Fear and great joy. Nalaman nila ang kanilang master, ang kanilang teacher ay buhay. Still their heart, they become excited. Great joy. Madaling explain ang great joy eh. They were so thrilled and excited to know that Jesus is alive. Tinignan yung tomb, wala doon. They were so excited. They saw how Jesus was hanging on the cross despite of his pain and anguish. They knew Jesus conquered and overcome death. And because of him overcoming death, anong promise, anong sinabi na Jesus will come to pass, and it gives them assurance that his word is true. They were so excited. Pero even with their great joy, my fear, may mixed emotions sila. They were afraid. Look at this. They were fearful. So what does it mean to have fear? Many times when we encounter something that we don't understand, when we are entering to a situation unknown, there is fear. May kaba. So these ladies, may mga kaba. When your people are encountering something unfamiliar, they feel uncertain, insecure, unsure because they're not in control. Ang response nila ay takot. Now, remember the first time you came to Singapore? Tanong sa katabi mo, kamusta nun? When the first time you came to Singapore, sino hindi takot? Excited, right? May mix na happy ka, may trabaho ka na sa Singapore, but at the same time, may takot ka, ano mangyayari? Right? I remember when Pastor Jerry said, Roel, magpunta ka mission trip sa Mindanao. I was fearful kasi hindi pa ako napunta doon. Ilocano ako, one. May dugo ako, Ilocano. So, northern part sa Mindanao. So, I was fearful to bring some people with me to go mission trip. May takot, may kaba. Because there are times in what the Lord asking you to do is not your comfort zone. So take note, there are times in our life that God will push you to move out from your comfort zone. There's great joy, but at the same time, there is fear. I remember when I first time went to school here in Singapore. I was grade 3. The first day when we went to the principal, nag-apply kami, and then suddenly, oh sige, pwede ka nang pumasok. Bumili ng book, alam mo ang bag ko? Yung red na plastic bag. But I was so fearful because I don't speak Chinese. I don't speak Indian. I don't speak Malay. I was grade 3. I don't speak English. Kunti lang English ko. Bagsak nga English ko sa Pilipinas eh. Pero ngayon, nag-speak English na ako. One. The first day of my school, I was so afraid. The first day you enter in your employer's house, were you afraid? Afraid. The first time you enter the airplane, sasakay ka ng airplane, Philippine Airlines, o Cebu Pacific, papunta Singapore, hindi ka takot? O uminom ka ng pampatulog? You will be full of fear and hear what happened. Not only they're full of fear because uncertain ano mangyayari sa kanila. The angel said, go to the disciples and tell them. But they were going with great joy, but at the same time, full of fear kasi hindi nila alam ano mangyayari. But you know what gave them assurance? Despite of the fear, look at the text what Jesus said to them and comforted them. What did he say? Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. It's a familiar voice. A voice that they often hear teach is the voice of Jesus. Do not be afraid. It was personal to them. Do not be afraid. You see, it brings assurance that everything will be fine. Do not be afraid. I tell you, as people who love God and love Jesus, one thing about us, we're not worshiping a dead God, but a God who's alive and is speaking to us today. He speaks to us through His Word. He speaks to us in our inner, through the Holy Spirit, and He speaks to us in our situation. And He speaks to us and said, do not be afraid. The moment that we'll be discouraged. But remember this, mga kapatid. The moment that we will be hopeless and distraught. Remember God, Jesus is not dead. He still speaks today. And is telling you, do not be afraid. He turns to fear and joy. Second, from confusion and aimlessness to what? To active and purposeful. You look at the women, that sudden change to the women's composure. They were intending to go to the tomb to just watch and see. Pero ngayon, nabasa natin sa text, takbo ng takbo ngayon sila. Have you ever gone to the, anong tawag doon? Sa cemetery? Lapid ba? Lapida. Hindi si Rito pa lapida. Lapida. When you go there, there's a few times I went, I be very emotional when I go to my mom's. So emotional, hindi. And if you would just put yourself into the shoes of these women, they will be feeling the same way. Because they have lost their master. They'll be going there. But you know, because of Jesus' resurrection, it turns them from that posture na parang sad, down, aimless. But when they realize that Jesus is alive, it awakened them. Nagising ang kanilang buhay. Kaya sabi mo sa katabi mo, wake up. You see, the resurrection of Jesus Christ awaken us. Awaken us. from confusion to aimlessness, he turns us to be active and purposeful. Not only the women, the disciples. You noticed here, the disciple was dispersed. They were everywhere. They were confused. And some of them will be feeling guilty. Bakit? Iniwan nila si Jesus. Sabi nga nila, hindi kayo tayo iiwanan. Pero yung pala, pag namating yung mga soldier, iniwan lahat. Probably they were guilty of what they have done for denying and abandoning their master. But you know what Jesus said? Tell the disciple to go where? Galilee. Why Galilee? Have you ever pondered why Galilee? Pwede naman si Jesus pumunta sa Jerusalem at mag-meeting. Bakit sa Galilee? What's so significant about Galilee? You know why? Because Galilee is the place where everything begins to their life. You see, verse 10, and Jesus said to them, do not be afraid, go to tell the brothers to go Galilee. Why? Galilee is the place where everything began in their life. This is the place where they call out the fishermen to follow him. This is the place they were able to feed the thousands. This is the place they will be able to see Jesus heal the sick and then cast out demons. This is the place they encounter God. This is the first time they met Jesus. A place where they were first called. One thing we learn here, Jesus' resurrection reminds us that God gives restoration. He brings restoration. Christ's resurrection reminds us that God can bring restoration in the moment of defeat of this or discouragement. In a moment na parang hopeless ka na. Probably you've been so far away from God. But Christ's resurrection will you bring you back to that first point where you meet Him. You see, this, is there any part in our life that we have disappointed Jesus? Maybe full of guilt, discouragement, confusion. But you know, God wants to bring us back and give us a restart. So turn to the person beside you and tell the person, restart. So resurrection of Jesus Christ reminds us that God can restore the purpose of our lives and also encourage us to press on towards the goal that God gave us. Lastly, we read in the text the submission and restoration of worship. I love this. In verse 9, and behold, when Jesus appeared, Jesus said, greetings. What did they do? They came up and took hold of his feet. It means they bowed down and took hold of his feet. It means submission to God. And then they worship him. The resurrection of Christ reminds us that the God that we worship is not dead, but he is alive. Because he's alive, he still works in our lives. We worship because he deserves our praise. We worship because he alone is worthy. We worship because it's more than an emotion that we feel, but a truth that we hold on that Christ has risen and he deserved to be worshiped. Now, if you look at the book of Revelation, nakita natin dito, they were worshiping. It says, saying the loud voice, worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honor and glory and blessing. And I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under earth and the sea and all that's in them saying what? To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be blessing and honor and glory and might forever and ever. They were worshiping Jesus. Jesus did not remain in the grave. His resurrection and our response is worship. There's a song that we often sing many years ago. Itong awit na ito. How can I say thanks for the things you have done for me? Things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me. The voices of the million angels could not express my gratitude. All that I am and ever hope to be,
I read all to thee. Yung chorus, to... Oh, pasado ang choir. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory for the things He has done. With His blood He has saved me. With His power He has raised me. To God be the glory for the things He has done. I know some of you came from Philippines and when you came to Singapore, umaman kayo. Tingnan mo yung brand ng sapatos na katabi mo. Some of you branded. Some of you came to Singapore bago ay dumating sa Singapore, ang buhok niyo ay kulot. Ha? Nagpariban na kayo. Some of us here have been blessed so many things in life. But all those things are just toys. But the greatest blessing we can ever have is because Jesus has redeemed us. Amen? Amen. And that can never be taken away. Never. Wherever you go, you'll be rich when your Jesus is in your heart. Palakpakan natin ating Panginoon. Some of you came to Singapore, sabi, Pastor, dito lang ako sa Singapore na kumain ng cake. Hindi lang isa. Hindi lang dalawa. Hindi lang tatlo. Lima pa. And some of you said that. Yes, all the experience we have in this life, in this place, in this earth, even in Singapore, those are good, but yet the greatest gift we can ever have in life is we have a Savior who loves us, redeems us, who is alive. And our response is worship. Worship. Because He deserves our praise. As I summarize all this thing, I call upon the worship team. See, Christ's resurrection is supernatural. Say supernatural. Supernatural. It also revealed a grand revelation of who Jesus is. That He's not just a teacher, not a prophet, not just a Messiah that defined by their culture, but He's God. Third, Christ's resurrection. I asked early on how it should impact your life. Christ's resurrection should reorient our life. It should lead us to live a life that's different from the past we live. You know, there's a song that we always then sing as I call upon the worship team. Ito, when I would research, anong background ng awit na ito? Ang background ng kantang ito, you know, because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Bakit sinulat niya ito? Ito ang sabi niya. Okay. Because He lived was written in the midst of social upheaval, threats of war and betrayals of nation and personal trust. It was into the world in such a time we were bringing our third little baby, kaya may baby doon. Assassination, drug, traffic, and war monopolized the headlines. It was in the midst of this kind of uncertainty that the assurance of the Lordship of the risen Christ blew across our troubled minds, like a cooling breeze in the parched desert.
Then as he hold the baby, sabi ng author and writer, holding our tiny son in our arms, we were able to write how sweet to hold our newborn baby and feel the pride and joy he gives. But greater still, the calm and assurance this child can face uncertain day because he lives. Because he lives, we can face tomorrow. Amen? I'll end this with a short testimony. About 10 to 12 years ago, we were able to go to Mindanao, sa Pilipinas, for a mission trip in Living Word Fellowship. So it's been for me, I've not been to my hometown for more than 10 years plus. So a lot of change. So pag uwi ko noon, after the mission trip, I went to move at, pumunta kami sa aking lugar, sa San Pedro, Laguna. And I visited my mom and pinuntahan ko si mama. Si mama, galing kami sa mission trip. Ito. And I just want to just drop by sa Pilipinas, sa aming lugar. And when we were talking, sabi ni mama sa akin, Ruel, kagagaling nyo lang sa mission trip, pwede mong puntahan yung kapitbahay natin. Si Sister Shawnee ang pangalan niya. And bakit ma? Dahil meron siyang cancer of the bones. Pag-pray mo, baka mahil. Si mama to talaga. Sige, sabi ko, sige, why not? Pag-pray ko siya. Galing ako sa mission trip eh. On fire. Oho. On fire. You must see the background is this lady. Siya ang nag-mentor sa parents ko. Siya yung Christian in our subdivision. She's been the one who mentored my parents and my mom and my dad. And she's one of the church leader. So I went to her house and visited. Eh, siyempre yung nanay. Ang nanay palagi nagpapapogi sa anak eh. Sister Shawnee, ang anak ko pumunta sa mission trip. Oo. And when I entered the room, si Sister Shawnee ay nandun sa small bed. Cramped into a small space. Couldn't lift up her hand. Couldn't lift up her fingers. Because of the pain in her bones. She was lying there on the bed, bedridden. She couldn't rise. At alam ni Iwox yan. And we were there and I was ready to pray for that lady. Gusto kong pag-pray agad eh. And then when I look at her and I look eye to eye, Ruel, tumaba ka na. Lumaki ka na. So Ruel, yan. She was full of smile despite what she's going through. And I was looking at her. I was about to pray, Lord! Instead, what you know what she did? She talked about, anong ginawa mo sa Mindanao? Anong ginawa mo? And the words that comes to her lips is, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. I couldn't enter, kamusta kayo? Because her lips is full of praising God. At the end, alam mo sino nag-pray? Siya ang nag-pray sa akin. I saw in her a woman, despite of her limitation, despite of her sickness, she can face each day with joy in her heart because Jesus is alive. Because Jesus is alive. I don't know what you're going through, mga kapatid. Some of you, your loved one is sick. Some of you have problems in your relationship in the family. Some of you might have lost your job. Some of you are a question, what's next, Lord? Some of you are struggling in ministry, but remember this, mga kapatid. Jesus has risen, and He is alive. Amen. And we shouldn't stay in that victory, in that defeated state. Paminsan tayo mga Christian, gusto natin magstay dun sa defeated state. But you know, Resurrection Sunday, Jesus rose up to bring joy in our heart. When the disciples were experiencing and saw Jesus, not all the things changed. They are still persecuted by people, but deep inside their heart, they can face tomorrow because Jesus lives. Amen. Pinag-pray niya ako. Siyempre, pinag-pray ko na rin siya. But that was the last time I met her. But it's in my mind, in my heart. No matter the situation we go through, kahit bedridden pa siya, the joy can never be taken away.
because Jesus is in our heart. Let's stand. Let's sing this song, God Sent His Son. Worship Him. Hallelujah.
God sent His Son.
Let it be our prayer this afternoon.
They call Him Jesus. He came to love.
Healing. My pardon.
To buy my pardon, an empty grave is there to prove my Savior.
Come on, church, let's lift our hand and declare in this place.
Because He I can face tomorrow because He lives. All fear is gone. And because I
yes, Lord. How sweet.
How sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy.
But greater still,
but greater still, the come assure
this child,
this child can free.
Come on, church,
and free.
Let's declare in this place, oh Jesus, you live. We worship you. We
because He lives.
Hallelujah.
I can face tomorrow because He lives.
All fear,
all fear is gone.
is what we're gonna do at this moment. We're gonna pray for one another to remind each other that our Lord has risen. Amen? Amen. So find a prayer partner in twos. Find somebody that we can pray and encourage one another. So let's just go around, elders, leaders. Let's see if anyone have no partner. Ano po tayo na mas maganda hindi kilala? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's just pray for one another. Remind each other. He holds the future. And life is worth living just because He lives. And because He lives. You have completed praying, invite all of us to stand and just sing this song.
Praise God.
Let's just worship the Lord continually.
And because
the benediction, let me end with this simple testimony. I mentioned about that lady who was praying. When we were praying, she was full of smile. And that picture is always in my mind, in my heart. She was able to smile in the midst of storm. She was able to smile in the midst of her sickness. Sa kanyang personal struggle, because he know Jesus is alive. And was looking at her, you know what song reminded me? You know, I don't want to end this Resurrection Sunday in a posture na parang defeated tayo. You know, as Christian, we are not to be defeated, right? Because we have a victorious God. Amen? We have a victorious God. Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. Bago tayo, amen. Yes, we have a victorious God.
Amen.
Kaya bago tayo mag-dismiss o mag-resurrect. Magbigay ng
awitin natin itong awit na to. You know, we're gonna go out there victorious because Jesus conquered the grave. Amen?
Amen.
Wherever your situation is, we're gonna trust the Lord. He said, Lord, you have conquered it all. In this world, we have tribulation, but you have conquered it. Amen? Kaya awitin natin to, and I invite all of us to just go and find about 5 or 10 people and shake that hand and remind that person na ang buhay ng Kristiyano ay masaya. Ang buhay ng Kristiyano ay masayang tunay. Masayang tunay. Let's go around! Ang buhay ng Kristiyano ay masayang tunay. Masayang tunay. One more time! Ang buhay ng Kristiyano ay masayang tunay. Masayang tunay. Masayang tunay. Ang buhay ng Kristiyano ay masayang tunay. Masayang tunay. For the last time! Ang buhay ng Kristiyano ay masayang tunay. Masayang tunay. Masayang tunay. Ang buhay ng Kristiyano ay masayang tunay. Masayang tunay. Palakpakan natin ating Panginoon. We have a reason to celebrate because Jesus is alive. Let's just raise a hand and receive the benediction. May you grow in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To Him be the glory both now and to the day of eternity. Lord, as we face the brand new week, as we face the brand new year, Lord, I pray that we will not walk in defeat, but we will walk in victory because you have defeated, Lord, the grave, that you have overcome the world. And I pray that we will embrace that in our lives, Lord, wherever situation we are in, Lord. We will hold in your promises. We will walk in the power of your Spirit. So come have your way, Lord, and we will rejoice. We will be filled of gladness in our heart because you are alive in the mighty name of Jesus. And everybody say, Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Just turn to the person and said, see you next Sunday. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you for coming to service. See you next Sunday. God bless everyone. Masayang tunay, masayang tunay, ang buhay ng Kristiyano ay